Meet, Paleo Magazine, the Well-Being Journal, and the International Society of Sports Nutrition. Sun Warrior, you can get it at Vitamin Shoppe, put it in your smoothie at Smoothie King. It is a premier, all-natural, raw superfood company dedicated to providing the best vegan plant-based protein powders and supplements. Go to sunwarrior.com to learn more about all of their products. And, of course, Honest Hemp. Visit them at honesthemp.com. Happy, healthy, honest. Their products are natural alternatives for managing your stress, reducing mild anxiety, and relieving pain from exercise-induced inflammation. Of course, Paleo Magazine and the Well-Being Journal, two of my favorite publications. I read them regularly, and I have for years. And our new sponsor, Nature's Plate, is a Dallas-based store that offers plant-based meals to go. They offer handcrafted, 100% vegan, always non-GMO, ready-to-go meals to help lighten your cooking and save you from the grocery store. I'm not going to say the dreaded grocery store, because when I have time, I do love to go to the grocery store and smell the tomatoes.
Oh, it can be a great experience.
Absolutely. It's a good place to slow down, but when you can't, Nature's Plate makes it really easy to eat healthy, and what you're eating benefits not only you, but the environment too. So visit them at naturesplate.com. You can order ahead. I don't do that because I like to go in and see. I like to just do it. I'm kind of a hands-on kind of person. If I'm not going to go to the grocery store, I'm at least going to walk into Nature's Plate like I did yesterday. It was great. And how was that? I brought in those carrot cookies, and I borrowed one from Marie last week, and I had to repay her.
Those carrot cookies are the bomb.
And they're really...
I just finished her cookie that she started, so sorry, Marie.
They're so good. It's a great breakfast item to or take on the go or send it with your kids. But always great having Dr. Mike McFarland, PhD, in studio with us. He is a licensed psychologist in the state of Texas with a private practice in Dallas. Dr. Mike provides individual therapy to adolescents through adulthood, and he specializes in the treatment of anxiety disorders, obsessive compulsive spectrum disorders, which is OCD, which I think I might be a little bit, and male body image and eating disorders. You can find him at his website, McFarlandPsychology.com. We're talking today about identifying and treating binge eating disorder. So what exactly is a binge eating disorder, Dr. McFarland?
Well, we are all familiar with the concept of binge eating, and many of us think to ourselves, oh, well, I just binged.
I probably do it every day,
Okay. Well, probably not. Probably not.
Because I got up and I made popcorn last night at like 10:30.
Oh, I did too.
I did. Popcorn at 10:30, and one bowl wasn't enough. Even though I went all the way back into my bedroom, I got out. The popcorn made me get back out of bed. I'm blaming it on the popcorn and go get another bowl. And maybe
must
I didn't have enough
really
for dinner.
Popcorn.
I don't know. But
it could have been. So a way of thinking about binge eating disorder, first of all, it's different from just binging, because we can all binge kind of with a lowercase b. Binge eating disorder is something that's much bigger, and it's an actual eating disorder. So you would think about it in the cluster of disorders like anorexia nervosa or bulimia, for example. But binge eating disorder was added as a specific type of disorder back in 2013 to the DSM-5, which is a Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders.
What makes it so severe or so extreme that it has to have its own diagnosis?
Well, so specific criteria. You have to, for beginners, you have to binge at least a minimum of once a week for 3 months to get this diagnosis. And a binge, what that entails is essentially eating way more than would normally be expected during, let's say, a two-hour period for one of those binges. There's along with that got to come with a sense of being out of control. Like you can't rein yourself in.
Okay.
You're just eating. It's considered an impulsive or compulsive disorder, because once it starts, there's very little ability to pull yourself back from that behavior.
Wow.
And so then you've also got to have, there's several other criteria, but you have to have at least three of the following things. It's either eating very rapid, much more rapidly than normal. You know, you might be just shoving the food in your face.
Wow.
Feeling uncomfortably full, not just a little bit full, but oftentimes feeling sick, like you might, you know, throw up. Eating large amounts of food even when you're not hungry. So you might just be kind of bored and then something clicks in your head, or you might be distressed and something clicks in your head and you head for the kitchen, and that's when it starts. There's oftentimes a sense of feeling very embarrassed by what you've just eaten, and oftentimes wanting to eat alone because you don't want other people to see how you're eating, and then a sense of feeling very disgusted with yourself or depressed or very guilty afterwards.
That's never good. Shame and guilt is such a low emotion. It's
exactly.
Really so unhealthy.
That's right, and it sets up a following a cycle. So oftentimes people experience this shame and guilt. They say, I'm never going to do this again. They start restricting. They might go several 12 hours or so without eating. Meanwhile, they're getting more and more hungry. Their ability to exert self-control diminishes.
Mm-hmm.
And as that hunger increases, finally they snap and they're right back at it again.
So can it be triggered, if you will, by like, so you said, you know, all this intermittent fasting has really, really become popular.
Yes.
Can it induce this kind of like eating disorder by, you know, starving yourself for so many hours and then you're so ravenous that you might overeat?
It could for some people, especially the ones that are going extreme with it, where maybe they're engaging in fasting for 16 hours at a time or something like that.
Yeah.
That's pretty extreme and it sets you up for it. But it wouldn't necessarily create that dynamic in everyone. You kind of have to be susceptible to it.
Wow. We ran out of time.
That's okay.
Gosh darn it. Well, I had some other questions too, but maybe next time you're in, we'll talk about the same thing and dig a little deeper into it.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Always a pleasure having you in studio, Dr. Mike McFarland.
Thank you for having me.
You can find him at McFarlandPsychology.com. Wow, this show went fast. That means it was a good one. So, everyone, thank you so much for listening. We always enjoy doing this show. You know what? You get one body, you get one mind, and you get one life. Get out there today and make the most of it.
Do recent media reports of unvaccinated children causing the return of measles have you worried? Could this manufactured media push be another symptom of the epidemic of fake news plaguing our nation? Let Texans for Vaccine Choice offer this cure for measles mania. 98% of students enrolled in Texas schools are up to date on their measles vaccine. We invite you to learn more about protecting your rights as we rally and fight for our freedom. For more information, go to TexansForVaccineChoice.com. Again, that is TexansForVaccineChoice.com.
Hi, I'm Bob Barker, and this is my friend Benny. Before you buy cosmetics, personal care, or household products, you be sure they have not been tested on animals. Everything from floor cleaner to shampoo is poured into animals' eyes and down their throats. They suffer intensely. Some even go blind. The price is never right for products tested on animals. Visit PETA.org for a list of cruelty-free companies.
Hey y'all, I'm so excited to tell you about my most recent obsession, Nature's Plate, and let me tell you why. Nature's Plate is plant-based meals to go. They offer handcrafted, 100% vegan, always non-GMO, ready-to-go meals to help lighten your cooking, save you from the dreaded grocery store, and help you lose weight. I have to say, I have been eating their meals now for a couple of weeks, and I already have lost weight naturally while feeling nurtured and satisfied after every meal. And here's why. The one thing about Nature's Plate that is so beneficial is that their meals are nutrient dense but without all the calories. They also have a rotating menu so you aren't stuck eating the same thing every week. There's 3 convenient locations in the Dallas area and they even offer delivery options. Nature's Plate makes it so easy to eat healthy and what you're eating benefits not only you but the environment too. Find a location near you or order online. Go to naturesplate.com. That's naturesplate.com.
Hello, I'm Allie McGraw for People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. Our animal companions rely on us, especially during a natural disaster. If you're forced to evacuate your home, do not leave your animals behind. Visit helpinganimals.com.